Sellers, stop leaving money on the table. My name is Mike Perna with Keller Williams Realty. I'm going to talk to you for just a few minutes today on some of the phenomenon that I'm seeing in the market that makes just absolutely no sense to me. And I'm going to kind of deep dive into it to take it apart. So I am seeing all these posts by real estate agents and by sellers and by a lot of people saying sold in one day, sold in one day, sold in one day. I've sold my home in one day. Now, here's a problem with this. I believe, in fact, I'm pretty darn certain that if we're selling a home in one day in this market, we are leaving money, we are leaving time, we are leaving terms, we're leaving a lot on the table that should be yours. Now, here's what I mean by this. So right now, per the multiple listing service, the average showing is receiving 34 requests to see it. 34 requests. Our homes are going a little bit above 40, or actually well above 40 in a lot of cases, which is a testament to our marketing. Now, if we've got 34 people or families that have requested to see this property, and we're showing that property from 9 a.m. to 9 p.m. in half hour increments, the absolute max we could get into that property, into your property, the max number of buyers is 24. So if they did one full round of showings, right, and then accepted an offer at 9:30 p.m., there are still 10 families out there that did not get the opportunity to see or bid on your property at a minimum. At a minimum. Now, a lot of our buyers are contacting us, or we're seeing that property come up that day and we cannot get the showing because it's completely blocked out, right? Even though we're watching the market every single day for our buyers, a lot of times 2 hours into a property being listed, that one day is completely done. So we have to go to the next day. There's just no more availability, right? Because a lot of that got snapped up. And if a seller's accepting an offer when it's only one day on market, my buyers and other buyers and many, many more people did not get the opportunity to see that property. This is why who you get into business with matters, right? The stats are great. They look nice. They're fluffy. But the reality is you really need 2, 3, or sometimes 4 days to ensure that you're getting the most you can out of that asset. At this point, guys, the home has become a house when you're going to sell it. And that's part of our job is to remain that third party person to assist you in making those right moves to ensure you're maximizing your investment, right? And also avoiding double moves, avoiding double payments, all of that, right? So here's what this looks like in our world. So when we put a home on the market, the first thing we do is we put all of our properties active as a coming soon on Tuesday, okay? So Tuesday, all of Tuesday and all of Wednesday, it's out there for the realtor community and their buyers to see. Now, a lot of that data is being transmitted to the third-party sites at that point, our Zillows, our realtor.coms, owner.com, like all of those different sites, like 300 or 400 sites. I'm not going to get into all of them, otherwise this will be a half an hour video. So they now have the data prepped to go active. On Thursday, we're turning all of our properties active, Thursday and Friday, right? And then the general public can go and see that as well. However, we're still not starting showings until the open house at 1 p.m. on Saturday, okay? Now, here's the reason for this. So if I put a property live on Thursday, that home will not show up on most sites for general buyers to see it, right, who are just searching around, like a Zillow or a realtor.com. It won't show up till Friday, even as late as Friday afternoon or evening. So by then, if I'm a real estate agent, I throw a property on the market and I just start showings immediately, my Friday is booked and I'm getting a lot of great offers right there on Friday before half the buyers out there even see it and knows that it exists, right? So we're starting the showings delayed by 2 days, and this is very purposeful, and we're starting with an open house. Here's the other reason for this, right? We're finding, especially this time of year, a lot of agents have families, they're on the spring break vacations, they're doing all of those things with the families they should, but what that also means is their buyers will not be able to get into your home and see it until it's gone. And that's a problem. That's a problem, right? So we're hosting that open house for two people right now. Agents are buyers with agents that are not available to show the property, so the clients can't get in and the agents protected, because I want that offer for you, Mr. Seller. I do. I want that offer for all of my sellers, right? Second, people that don't have agents, and there are a significant number of people that are shopping in the market right now that don't have agents. I want to be sure that they get in, because with those electronic lock boxes, if you do not have a real estate license, you cannot access that property, period. Now, we are being upfront with everyone and saying we're not even looking at offers. We're not even looking at offers until minimum Sunday evening, or in a lot of cases right now, Monday evening. And here's the reason why. If we start and we're able to get, let's call it 20 people through, sans the open house, because that's a different thing. But let's say we're able to get 20 buyers through on Saturday, 20 buyers through on Sunday, but we still have another lingering five or six for Monday they need to get in. I want to be dead sure every single buyer had their opportunity to get into your home and make their and put their best foot forward with their very best bid. Doesn't mean that I'm not going to be in great communication with those agents to inform them what's going on along the way. I will be. I will definitely be letting them know when we hit offers 2, 5, 7, 8, 10, whatever that looks like. Because I also want those agents to be able to go back to their buyers and frankly, bring you more dollars or better terms. And here's what that looks like. In a lot of cases, I'm seeing agents push sellers to accept offers on day one when they have two or three offers. The problem here is a lot of these offers are missing appraisal guarantee clauses. Now, in layman's terms, what this means is if the buyer's unwilling to pay more than the appraised value, then that appraisal will become another point of negotiation. And frankly, 20% of offers are falling apart right now that are accepted. Another point where one out of five offers are falling apart, right? If I have five or six or seven offers, then I can start going back on your behalf, right? And start getting those terms back in there. Like, hey, if the property appraises 30,000 below it, the buyer's got to bring that extra cash. Can they do that? And here's the issue, guys. Right now, appraisals are 90 to 180 days behind current market value. And in a lot of cases, it's up to 270 days behind. And that's simply because there's been a lack of properties that have sold and this market being on fire has shot up dramatically. So right now, the market is going up about 1.5% per month, right? So let's just use some simple numbers. If we've got a $300,000 house and it's been 4 months since anything sold in that neighborhood, that $300,000 house is now worth 6% more than that previous sale, right? If you have apples to apples, once we adjust for square footage and all those things. But here's the problem. The appraiser can't use that number, that 6% number, because as appraisals have changed back in 2008, as they should, they can only use real data. They can't extrapolate new numbers. So if that home sold for $300 in that neighborhood and I've got a $318,000 offer, that appraisal is going to come out of 300. One of two things are going to happen. Either the buyer's got to come up with extra money or that deal is going to die because I'm going to go find a different buyer that will. Now, if the deal dies, it's a bad thing for the sellers because it can throw off their move. This is why I want to pre-negotiate as many of these terms as possible, which I'm able to do when I have 6 to 8 offers on the property. It's much harder to do midway through the transaction when we're only working with one buyer at that moment. Right. So I definitely want to put you in the best place for your move on two different levels. One, so that it's stress free. You don't have to worry about appraisals or anything like that. And then two, we ensure it's going to happen. Right. And that's another thing that we look at is we look at the lenders as much as anything else, because right now what we're finding is many of these offers are coming in at roughly the same price within a 500 or 1,000 of each other, the top three or four bids, which is great. And some buyers are still choosing to work with fly-by-night lenders or spaghetti theory lenders. And when I say spaghetti theory, no offense to the lending community, you guys all know, yeah, in the realtor community, the same. There are some people out there that are not necessarily professionals and they're not technicians and they're not masters of the craft. Spaghetti theory lenders and spaghetti theory realtors are both the same. Let's throw it all up against the wall, see what sticks, right? And the person that wins is the lender, because some of those loans are going to make it and they're going to be able to take home some money for their family. The people that lose are the buyers and the sellers. The buyers and the sellers, the seller who does not achieve that closing and get their money out of the property, and the buyers who trusted that fly-by-night lender but can't achieve an actual approved status, right? So a lot of things to unpack in this video, a lot of things that left to unpack. And guys, this is part of it, but this is most definitely not all of it. So when you see those things out there, sold in one day, be a little leery. Great that they sold it in one day, but what could they have sold it for if they had waited just another 24 or 48 hours, had a little patience, right? And if that number is a $10,000 increase in price for that, the increase in number for that family, increase in what you get back out of the closing, I'm gonna tell you right now, I don't know of any days I've ever made $10,000 in one day before. So in my world, I believe, and I advise my sellers, it's worth it to wait that second, third, or sometimes even fourth day to be sure we've got every hat in the ring from every buyer, not just the one buyer that looks pretty darn good on day one. Okay. Thank you guys. I appreciate it. Give us a call if you're thinking about buying, thinking about selling. We are happy to help out and we're happy to lend you our expertise. 248-221-1224. Make it a great day.